There is always a thin line distinguishing formal and informal sector. And this has caused a lot of confusion among academics and policymakers on an acceptable definition of the informal sector. But perhaps I think what we all agree to and know to be widely acceptable is the definition which is put forward by the International Labour Office, which defines the informal sector as all activities by workers and economic units that are in law or in practice not covered or insufficiently covered by formal arrangements. Workers in the informal economy often are not registered, they do not appear in the national statistics, and are not covered by social protection, labor legislation, or other protective measures in the workplace. Work can be unsafe and unhealthy. A worker's employment status can be uncertain, and productivity and income are often low. So as a result, work is often insecure and vulnerable, and often there's lack of access to productive resources such as finance and land, which combined with low skills, confines them to low income work. We also know that in the informal economy, there are often some formal sectors, and this has been documented by Fox and Milner, Filmer, in their 2014 research. There are also, there may also be formal firms in the informal sector that voluntarily remain informal to avoid taxes or registering their workers. I have just three slides, and if the first slide can be put on the screen, that would be useful. The first slide looks at the age variations in employment that are distinctively similar across regions. And an interesting regional variation can be discerned in the level of informal employment. When you look at the share of informal employment in total employment, it shows a bunching close to 90% for three sub-Saharan African regions: West Africa, East Africa, and Central Africa. Southern Africa, as the chairman just said, is an outlier. It has the lowest, below 40% of adults over 25 are in this informal sector. North Africa also shows a lower share of informal employment, much lower than the African average. I believe you've seen this data on the graph. The second slide also shows informal employment, which falls with education. The relationship between informality and education is inversely related. The highest informality is found among those who with no education, about 90%. This drops precipitously across all regions to below 50% for tertiary education. Again, Southern Africa, which is heavily weighted by South Africa, is an interesting outlier, where even informality among those without education is lower than those with secondary education in the other regions, except North Africa.